Bonjour everybody, welcome back to my channel, I hope you are doing well. For today's video, I've been really inspired by a new eyeshadow palette that we are going to be testing out today, and I created this fuchsia purpley pink eyeshadow look. So very excited for this video because I will be using the new eyeshadow palette from Zoeva, which is Heritage, and this palette, oh my gosh, screams spring and summer for me. It has a really beautiful pastel-y shades, and that's what I wanted to do today, a wearable pastel eye look with a bright color as well on the lips, so very also dewy, glowy and hydrating on the face. So if you want to see how I created this makeup look right here, perfect for spring that is coming around the corner, but also for summertime, using beautiful products today. Some are new, some are not. So if you want to see them in action and going through the process of this makeup look, you know what to do. Just keep on watching. Alright, so first thing first, I'm gonna prep my skin, and as usual, I'm gonna use a facial spray. And for today, I'm gonna be using the Mario Badiusco facial spray with aloe, cucumber, and green tea. And for today's look, I really want my base to be very glowy, radiant, and very illuminating. So for primer, I will be using this beautiful primer. It's Le Blanc de Chanel Multi-Use Illuminating Base by Chanel, and this baby here, I don't really remember how I feel about it because I haven't used this one for a hot minute, so I'm really excited to try it again today because I really don't remember how I feel about this one, but I remember back in the day it was a very popular and hyped up base primer. So yes, I'm really excited about this one. Yeah, as I remember, it's very liquidy and whitish pearly look, so this is going to give me the lightness I need. I'm gonna just apply it on all over my face, really. It looks like a sunscreen. So I'm massaging a little bit all over my face. Smells good, smells Chanel, obviously. Oh yeah, I can see the pearly particles really brightens up my skin. I'm really liking that. The texture is really nice as well. So yeah, good base to start with. Oh gosh, I need some hydration on my lips. I see they are so chapped and dry. I'm using Laneige Sleeping Mask in Berry Scent, my favorite. I do like my base to be very radiant and luminous, but still in my T-zone, I like to use a pore minimizing primer. So I will be using the Smashbox Photo Finish Pore Minimizing. So this, I'm gonna focus on my T-zone and my cheek where I have my pores, because it's gonna really smooth out my texture, my fine lines, and it's gonna diminish the appearance of my pores as well. This is such a really good primer, and if you have a combo oily skin, you will love that primer. The star of the show today is going to be my foundation, and I will be using Laura Mercier Flawless Lumiere Radiance Perfecting Foundation, and I have it in the shade 3W2 Golden, and I'm gonna take two pumps. So this foundation has a quite thick texture, so that's why I'm starting off with two pumps instead of one, and I will be using a damp beauty blender. So I'm starting from the center of my face and I'm going outwards like so. This foundation has such a beautiful coverage. For me, it's more like a good medium to full coverage, very buildable as well. And it looks so beautiful, radiant and natural. It doesn't feel cakey, it doesn't settle into the fine lines, it doesn't emphasize any texture as well. It is a really beautiful foundation. It wears really well throughout the day as well. And it's supposed to last up to 15 hours. I haven't worn that foundation for that long. And the shade is slightly too dark, but it's fine because now we are entering springtime, then it's going to be summer, so with my tan is gonna be perfect matching. So yeah, overall I need about 4 pumps with the beauty blender. I feel like it gives a more natural finish with the sponge than with the brush. And since I have combo skin but also dehydrated skin, this foundation really gonna bring back hydration as well, which is great for up to 15 hours, and it's gonna smooth out also my texture, my fine lines, any imperfection I may have. So overall, it is a really beautiful foundation because it really ticks out all the boxes I like in a foundation. And for my concealer today, I'm super excited because I will be trying out a new concealer, and the concealer of choice today is going to be the Laura Mercier Flawless Fusion Ultra Longwear Concealer, and I have it in the shade 2W. Because I loved the foundation so much, I really wanted to try the concealer as well. And I got it in a lighter shade because obviously my foundation is darker. So I really wanted a shade that will brighten up my under eye and also highlight a little bit my face while still covering my dark circle. So obviously this is first impression, so I don't know if it's gonna cover well. We're gonna find out together. But right off the back, I feel the texture very comfortable, very nice. It's more like a radiant finish as well, and I love that for my under eye because I do have like fine lines under my eye because it's dehydrated. So I like a very smooth hydrating concealer as well. With my beauty blender, I will blend it out. And the coverage is pretty good, pretty good. I do still see a bit of darkness, but a tiny bit. So I would say it's more like a medium coverage. And I think it can be buildable as well. But I'm really liking the finish. It's very natural and radiant as well. It's beautiful. I'm loving it. Why I didn't try this one sooner? It's very brightening and covering at the same time. Oh, I love that. They really do pair together, seriously. They're beautiful together. I kinda want to see if it's buildable, so I'm gonna add a little bit more, just where there's the halo, to see if it's buildable or if it's gonna get cakey, you know? Yes, it is buildable for sure. It's not getting cakey whatsoever. I'm really liking that, and that it's buildable is really great. New product I'm going to be trying today is my setting powder for my under eye and T-zone, and this is from Charlotte Tilbury. Yay! First of all, look at this packaging, so beautiful. And this is the Airbrush Flawless Finish Skin Perfecting Micro Powder in the shade 2 medium. And I'm gonna be using a brush from Charlotte Tilbury actually. Remember when I did that haul with the set they were having on their website? So I'm finally giving her products a try. If you can hear noise, it's my neighbor. One I think is hovering and the other one I think is watching Queens, I think. Because I can hear the song, so if I can hear it, I think you can hear it as well. So I'm apologizing for that. Yeah, nice powder, very smooth. Yeah, I'm liking the powder so far. So far, so good. I need obviously to keep using it, but seriously, I like how it set my under eye matte without looking cakey. So for that, I'm really liking it. And for the rest of my face, to keep that glow going on, I'm gonna be using the Laura Mercier, which is the translucent loose setting powder in the glow shade. How I use that powder is simply to use it on my cheekbones, my bridge of my nose, a bit on my temp and my chin to give a bit of a highlight effect. So I'm gonna be using this brush from Sigma. Lightly, gently, I'm swapping on this area to give that glow effect, you know, and then I'm going all over my cheek like so with what's left on the brush, and I found it really gave me that radiance without shimmer, and this is really really beautiful. But a little bit goes a long way, so you don't need much, otherwise you're gonna really look very over highlighted, but tiny bit is enough. And I love this brush with, seriously, it really applied the powder evenly, and I love that. You can control where you want to add and place your powder. So yeah, these two together, it's a match heaven. Now to contour a little bit my face to give some dimension and sculpt, I'm gonna be using the Charlotte Tilbury, the Filmstar Bronze and Glow. And I will be using the contour shade. And then I'm just sculpting my face to give some dimension, you know the drill. And of course for my highlight, I will be using the highlight part to add a bit of a glow, of course. And this is one of the most beautiful highlighters I've ever used, worn, own scene. It is a beautiful, beautiful highlight. And with that Laura Mercier Glow Base, it really gives us the ultimate glow. Still very natural, very beautiful, really. I want my face to be a little bit warm, so I'm gonna be using the bronzer from Anastasia Beverly Hills, and this one is the powder bronzer in the shade Saddle. Oh yeah, ooh. Oh yeah, I'm alive, because it's really giving me the sun-kissed effect and look I'm looking for, especially for, you know, a spring makeup look. Anastasia, I love your bronzer and blushes and eyeshadow palette. I love them all. Speaking of blush, I will be using a new blush today, and it's from Charlotte Tilbury, and it's the Cheek to Chic in a Pillow Talk. Again, the packaging, beautiful and stunning. And then when you see the color of this blush, Pillow Talk, oh, hallelujah, I love this kind of shade. It's my kind of shade, my everyday shade, and it's perfect. I'm super excited to give this a go and see how it looks on the cheek. So what I will do, I'm just gonna mix all together. Ooh, yeah. Color is so pretty, subtle and pretty. See that? Really nice. It reminds me a little bit of the Jouer Adore Duo blush, but this one is more pinkier, the other one is more neutral. Oh, that is pretty. I'm gonna just get that glow in the center on the apple of my cheek to give that extra glow, like so. Does it make a difference? I'm not sure, but I'm loving the color. Oh yes, I'm so happy I got it. Pillow Talk, yes. Perfect shade, seriously. Really beautiful. Now, the eyes. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited about this part because, again, we're gonna be trying out a new eyeshadow palette. But this palette is like, oh, I just love this palette. Ta-da! Zoeva Heritage Eyeshadow Palette. The packaging of this palette is just so beautiful, and from Zoeva, I'm not surprised because they always make really stunning and beautiful packaging, but from the inside is even more beautiful. Ta-da! Can you see? Can you see those colors? Those pastel, fuchsia, purpley, blue midnight, transition shades. Oh, I cannot wait to create a look today with it because it's just stunning, because I don't have this kind of colors, and I don't know, this really speaks to me. So first thing, I'm going to prime my eyes with MAC Painterly, and this is such a really good eye primer as well. Now to set my eye primer, I will be using that blanc beige cream shade, which is Narrat A Story. Such a beautiful as well shade, just to set primers or to start off your look with. It's like an universal shade for me. Now for my transition shade, I will be using this shade. It's a light brownish matte shade, and it's Anthropologie. I'm gonna zoom you. Hello. So into my crease with Anthropologie. It's like a camel shade, you know? It's between a camel and a brown shade. Very nice. Very pigmented as well. Zoeva eyeshadow palettes, they are one of the best in the market. Seriously, they are very affordable, very good price point, and the quality of the shadows, oh my gosh, they are really, really good. But it's more like a neutral shade, so it really goes well with any look you wanna do, because it's neutral, so it's not gonna come off weirdly, you know, if you use any colors. So that's what I like about this shade. Now, still into my crease, I'm gonna deepen up a bit the color, and I'm gonna be using this mauvey, purpley matte shade, and it's Written by the Winners. And I'm gonna concentrate the shade more so into the outer corner. And what I've got left on the brush, I'm going back forward, like so. I'm doing a back and forth motion. just to deepen up a little bit, you know. Beautiful shade, very pigmented as well. So you need to go light-handed with it. Now, time to play with purple. So I will be applying all over my lid this shade, it's Civilization, and I'm gonna apply it like so, all over my lid. And I'm gonna build up the color until the intensity I want. Yeah, I'm liking that. It's very subtle, but you can build up the color, which is good. If you want to keep it as it is, you can for a day eye look, but now I want to spice up a little bit the look, so I'm gonna be using that shimmery purpley fuchsia shade, which is Never Forget. It seems like a really beautiful fuchsia purpley shade, very pigmented, and as always I will be using my finger to apply that shade. You can use Fix Plus if you want to intensify the shimmer, but for me I like it as it is. I'm going back into Whiten by Winners with the pencil brush, and I'm gonna just add a bit of intensity on my outer corner. For my lower lash line, I will be using this khaki camel shade. Then I'm going back into that pink purpley shade, Civilization. Then I'm taking back my fluffy brush, I'm going back into that beige cream shade, and I'm just gonna soften up my edges so everything is seamless and blend together. Then for my inner corner, I'm gonna be using Monument, which is this beautiful silvery shade, pigmented as well. Then for my waterline, I will be using my Nude Rimmel eyeliner. But then the fun part, I will be using that Urban Decay 24/7 eye pencil in the shade Rio, something like that. And this, I'm gonna use it on my upper lash line. And also a little bit on my lash line. Now, off camera, I will be doing my brow with the Maybelline Brow Precise Fiber Filler in the shade Medium Brown, and my mascara with Lancôme Monsieur Big. So for my lips, I have two options. I have one more in a nude mauve everyday side, and the other one is more like a peachy, curly, bright color. But first thing first, I will be lining my lips with the Kiko Creamy Color Comfort Lip Liner in the shade 301. There you go, so I like also to fill in my lips with it. It's such a beautiful lip liner, very comfortable, very long lasting, and very pigmented. Then from the lip option, I will be using one from Charlotte Tilbury from their Matte Revolution line, and the other one is from Guerlain and it's from their Kiss Kiss line. So this one is the Matte Revolution Luminous Modern Matte Long Lasting Lipstick in the Pillow Talk shade, and the second one is the Kiss Kiss Lipstick by Guerlain in the Orange Peps shade. Here's the swatch, so this one is Pillow Talk by Charlotte Tilbury, this one is Orange Peps by Guerlain. Let's start with Pillow Talk. Such a pretty everyday shade, so very pink, nudish, mauvey kind of shade I wanna say, but the perfect everyday shade, and I feel like it pairs really well with the eye look. It's very flattering, very beautiful and nice, and it has like a satin matte finish, so very comfortable on the lips as well and very long lasting. Now let's go with the Guerlain. This is such a gorgeous shade. I feel like it's very summery and spring color, and plus with the purpley and pinkish fuchsia that we've got on the eyes, it really also pair really really well and really flatters the eyes as well. It's not too over bright as well, but it's like the perfect pigment with the orange corally peachy shade, so I feel like it's a good mix between these three shades, and yeah, I'm really really liking this color as well. And to finish off this look, I'm gonna set my face with the e.l.f. Dewy Setting Mist. And there you go guys, that's it, that's the final makeup look. Very dewy, very radiant and glowy, but yet very long lasting as well. I love how this look turned out. very fuchsia and purpley on the eye, but yet very wearable. So it's like an easy everyday look as well. If you don't like the extra shimmer on the eyes, you can keep it as matte as it was. But if you like that extra spice, the shimmer really sealed the deal with the eyes. But I've been really inspired by this palette, so I really wanted to play with pastel today and with some pink and purpley shades. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you found it entertaining and you had a really good time watching this video. If you did like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share with your friends. And if you are new to my channel, I hope you will consider subscribing before you leave. Thank you so much for watching and I cannot wait to see you in my next video. Until then, stay beautiful. Mwah. Bye.